So let's start this one with a disclaimer. This is not a substitute for a high-quality precision tool. So if you're looking at this as a professional, as an engine builder, you want to do a lot of engines and stuff, do not buy one of these. This is for the home guy who is going to do an engine, maybe two or three, an engine every couple of few years. He's going to do it and pass it off to one of his buddies. That's what this is for, okay? So here's the background on this. I have this block over here, and it's in decent shape, right? Doesn't need any machine work. The cylinder boards are good. Everything looks good. But the cam bearings were toast. So I says, all right, I got to slam some cam bearings in it. So I order cam bearings, and I run to the house, and I get my cam bearing installation set, and I don't have it. It's gone. Like, it's been gone for years, because I very rarely do cam bearings. I try to avoid it. We've talked about why we try to avoid doing cam bearings. And the last couple of times that I've had them done, it was the block goes off to the machine shop to be decked and bored and everything else, and hey, slam some cam bearings in there while you're at it. Well, this one doesn't need a trip to the machine shop, so we're going to do it here. So I says, all right, let me go online and let me buy a cheap camshaft bearing installation set. And I'm expecting to pay $150, $200 or thereabouts. A quality set's going to run you a few hundred. But like I said, it's $150, $200. So I go online and I see there's a set. Lyle has a set that's like $160. And Jegs has a set that's like $180. And I'm not really scrutinizing. I'm like, okay, well, that's about what I'm going to pay. And I'm about to pull the trigger on the Lyle set when I notice that there's one to the left of it. You know, the one you Google it, it comes up in panels. And I said, that's $64. Let me see the $64 one. So I look at the $64 one, and then I look at the Lyle one, and I look at the Jegs one, and I'm zooming in on the picture, and it's the same exact set. It's the same exact set. The color of the package, of the box, is different. You know, the plastic carrying case that it comes in, but the tools inside are exactly the same. Okay, this is a no-brainer. $63. Send me this thing. So this shows up yesterday. And typical mechanic. So this is supposed to be like an unboxing and tool review video. Well, okay, I cut it open beforehand. I got it here. I said, oh, let's see what this thing is. And I cut the box open and I says, no, wait, you're not a mechanic, you're a YouTuber. Ah! Sorry, guys. So you missed the part where I actually sliced the box open. But for the rest of our unboxing, okay, it's a low quality camshaft bearing installation tool. We have some instructions, Orion Motor Tech Universal Camshaft Bearing Tool User Manual. And it tells us, who's got time to read? All right, so let's see what we got here in this thing. So these would be the arbors that the cam bearing would fit into. Look, I have an equally low quality set of Chinese cam bearings. Don't kid yourself, guys. Like, all of this stuff, the tools, the parts, all of it is all made by the same pack of barefoot 9-year-old girls in Hunan province. It is what it is, you know. So we're going to do the number 4 cam bearing on that engine for demonstration purposes. So, okay, let's go to the motor for a second. So what I did ahead of time here, I pre-gamed a little bit, is when you're going to put cam bearings in a block, never leave anything to eye, right? You know, like, oh, I'll just line it up by eye. Don't do that, because you're going to be off just a little bit and you're going to hate life. So what I did here was on the number 4 is I took my straight edge, I found the center of everything, and I scribed the mark already in the block to line up with the oil hole of the cam bearing as I put it in. So just so that you know, it just takes it and just rams it in. No, I marked it first. So we've already got our scribe there. Okay. So number 4 Canberra. And that would be this one. Yes. All right. So these are the holders for the bearing. Okay. And they expand. It's just like a pipe expander. Okay. It's mounted on rubber. The rubber feels a little chintzy. Well, I mean, the metal is a little chintzy here too. Again, like this is not for heavy duty, you know, continuous, you're going to build an engine a day. No, this, but this will get the job done for our purposes. So we've got all of our different sizes here. This is a cone. This is to center the device in the block, like so. So this way you're driving straight through. This is the business end of it. So this is an expander. Okay, here you see. Behind it we've got an expander. And here we've got a ferrule. And as you tighten this, it pushes out on the expander, and that's where our rubber does its thing. So if we were gonna put this to use, let's see, first things first. We'll pick our correct size arbor. That looks like about it. Let's give this thing a squirt of lubricant. Oops. First day on the job, guys. This is unrehearsed. It's like live, no edits. Okay. It didn't bend, I guess it is quality. All right, so we're gonna put this on here. Yeah, and we're gonna put this on here. Okay, now we gotta tighten this up. Let me get a wrench for that. Hang on, right back. All right, so now we're not gonna be able to just feed this through the block. Maybe we can just feed this through the block. Let's see. All right, we're gonna put our cone on here, centering cone. Driver. Okay, that looks good so far. Feed this through. Back to the drawing board, guys. I picked the wrong bearing for that. This is actually number 2, not number 4. So here's our main oil hole, and then these two holes here line up with oil passages up in the block. So there's our oil hole, and this is, as we put it together, this is going to line up with the scribe mark that we already put on the block. So I'm going to snug I'm gonna snug that down. All the way set back. Little holes lined up. So what I'm doing right now is I'm tightening the expander to lock the bearing into the tool. And we're good. All right, so here, come here. So you see, here's our scribe mark on the block, and there's our oil hole, and directly lined up. And here's our cone, and it's important we got to keep the cone pushed up into the block, because that's what's centering all of this. You see, it's a lightweight bodywork hammer. I don't want to brutalize it. I gotta switch to a heavier hammer. Oh, heavier hammer, where are you? You can edit this part, Cat. Heavier hammer. Okay. A little more. Okay, it looks like I gotta go just another. Okay, the length of this is a bit of a problem because now I want to watch the bearing because I'm almost there. And I got to be way over here. Yeah. You almost need two people to do it with this thing here. That's it. That's it. All right, so now let's release this thing. How is this? It worked. It did the job. So for $65, $63, $64, $65, whatever the hell it was, in the mid-60s, delivered our it's no worse for wear. Our cheapo camshaft bearing installation tool seems to have done the job. Not bad. Four more and the job is done. What can I say? It got the job done. It got the bearing in minimum of hassle. If this was adjustable to different lengths, it's a universal tool, so they're making this so that you can drive in, like, you know what I mean? Giant engines. If this was a little bit more adjustable length, like another section in here, that would be great, because you just try to watch what you're doing and being over here, it's not the hot ticket. But nevertheless, it got the job done. And it's the same exact one, I'm telling you, if you're in the market for one of these things, go online, do a Google search on it, and zoom in on the picture of the components inside here and the components inside the more expensive kits, the ones that are more than twice the cost. And it's the same exact tool. So, I call it a success, I think. I don't know. It's a failure in that we can't make this stuff here affordably, quality, but take that up with the big guys. I'll see you tomorrow.